Hey guys, welcome to Real Time. Can you game with no GPU in 2021? In this video, we're going to test which of these onboard graphics are actually better, Intel's UHD 750 or AMD's Radeon Vega 7. Let's find out. Yes, these are very interesting times. If you're wondering why we are doing this video, yeah, that's a very good indication. With all the crypto mining resulting in extremely awesome, crazy-ass GPU prices, we think you should consider using onboard graphics for once. So, for Team Blue, we have the 1100K sitting on the MSI B560M Motai Wi-Fi with, yes, Gordon's very shiny pair of Trident Royal Zs. Trident Z Royals, actually.
Oh, so that's where the hell they went to.
Yep. On the red side, we have the 4650G. Unfortunately, there is no 4750G this time round, but we have the younger sibling, the 4650G, in its new home that we created for it, because it doesn't come with a box when you buy it. But if you want to know how the 4750G actually runs and it actually does very well, you can do so in the link above. Meanwhile, this guy is sitting on the MSI B550M Motai Wi-Fi. Let's not waste any more time, let's carry on with the test.
We'll start off with CSGO. 4650G Vega 7 on board does about an average of 130 to 140 FPS. While the UHD 750 or the 11900K lags behind that, I think you're looking at 30%, 40% performance deficit compared to the Vega 7. Next, we come to Rainbow Six Siege. Now for this, we are running it at 1080p, low settings, running on the Vulkan API. Now the first thing that you will notice is the Vega 7 on the 4650G has almost double the performance of the UHD 750. The UHD 750 does about 40 FPS on average. The 4650G does about 80+ FPS on average. Not only that, the one thing that we did notice when we were running the UHD 750, every now and then we saw like these white streaks and artifacting that run across the screen.
Call that the old color TV.
Yeah, the old color TV effect. We did have the time to test this out in DirectX mode, but since Vulkan is supposed to be the faster of the two APIs, so do take note of this if you intend to play Rainbow Six Siege with the Intel on board. Next, we come to GTA 5. Now, this is where things get really interesting because there is no difference between the two of them. As you can see, in the built-in benchmark, the average FPS is about 40, 50, 60 FPS, there about there. It's quite playable on both of them. At this setting, GTA 5 kind of looks something like GTA 4. Actually, even worse.
I think GTA 3.
Yeah, maybe GTA 3 Vice City. But that is how it is. As to why the Intel manages to be on par with the Vega 7 on the 4650G, my theory is that the 11900K having a much higher IPC per core than the 4650G, and this game being very much dependent on IPC, performance deficiency in the UHD 750 was compensated for by the 11900K's a much higher IPC. So it kind of helped to pull it up so that it matches on par with the 4650G.
Alright, so we have completed our runs. So yeah, we can easily conclude that you can actually play games using onboard graphics.
Yeah, provided you do manage your expectations, you turn the settings all the way down to low or the lowest thing.
1080p.
1080p. Yep. If you want even more FPS, you may probably even have to drop it down to 720p. But it is doable, especially from the Intel side. The UHD 750 is actually quite an improvement over the previous generations of all the UHDs that I cannot remember them.
Meanwhile, the red side has kept up its game.
I suppose that's the one thing good about competition brought on by this fella, as well as this predecessor, the 2000 series and 3000 series APUs, mm-hmm. has forced Intel to step up its game on the onboard graphics front.
Yep.
So they've gone from completely hopeless to
kind of playable
actually.
Yeah.
But I think the Intel one still has quite a fair bit to go. That one also has quite a fair bit to go before they can actually truly replace a matchup, even like a base level GPU. But if you're asking me which of these two would I actually pick, I'll take this one.
Yeah, it's way cheaper.
First of all, price is not really something I will look at because this is a freaking 11900K. But there are quite a couple of solid reasons I will pick that guy. Number one, this is using Vega architecture.
Yes.
It's basically a very junior version of the Vega 56 as well as the Vega 64. When you fire this thing up in DIMMs, especially for the more demanding titles, the AAA titles, there's more of a chance that this guy will run without issues. Dirt 5 started out without any problems because the DIMM engine probably saw this guy is just a AMD Radeon, so it just powered up just fine. But I think probably the moment he saw an Intel, this guy is not Nvidia, this guy is not AMD Radeon, thou shall not pass.
Yeah, or I go to sleep.
Yeah, yep. And I think you will probably find this the case for a lot of newer games.
Mm.
This guy will run a bad, you have to turn everything down.
Yep.
And this guy probably won't even start. Since this is a junior version of a Radeon, it does have some of the other features that all the other Radeons have. For example, it supports AMD FreeSync.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have a cheap and cheerful FreeSync monitor, like let's say a 1080p 75Hz FreeSync monitor, you plug it in, you will have FreeSync. Something to consider, especially when your frame rate are varying between like 75 to 60 to 50, you want a monitor that will be able to vary the refresh rate as you go along. This guy, however, doesn't have that, whether it's AMD's FreeSync or NVIDIA's G-Sync.
There's no Intel Sync.
Okay, there is one thing called the Intel Quick Sync.
Yeah.
But it's more relevant to people who are doing, like, let's say, video encoding and decoding, especially if you're using Adobe Premiere. Then yes, the Intel Quick Sync on this fella will come in handy. Yeah, do take note, however, that to enjoy Intel Quick Sync, you have to make sure to buy the Intel CPU that does not have a F at the end.
Yeah, we will look forward to Elder Lake comes out and Zen 4 comes out, because we hear that Zen 4 will have Navi based graphics and Elder Lake will have, I don't know, much better graphics. So
let's hope Raja Konduri pulls through. Let's see if he manages to finally pull it off with Elder Lake.
Yeah, Intel graphics, man, that will be quite competition for Nvidia and AMD.
More competition is good.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure to give us a thumbs up. Write down comments, what do you think of our choices for this or this, or what GPU do you actually want to use?
If you can find one.
So with that, goodbye and good night. Peace.